Good morning friends, I am Purva and today we will work out the following question. A fruit grower can use two types of fertilizer in his garden, brand P and brand Q. The amounts of nitrogen, phosphoric acid, potash and chlorine in a bag of each brand are given in the table. Tests indicate that the garden needs at least 240 kg of phosphoric acid, at least 270 kg of potash and at most 310 kg of chlorine. If the grower wants to maximize the amount of nitrogen added to the garden, how many bags of each brand should be added? What is the maximum amount of nitrogen added? And this is the table given to us. Let us begin with the solution now. Now we shall first formulate the linear programming problem according to the given conditions and then solve it. Now in the question we have, if the grower wants to maximize the amount of nitrogen added to the garden, how many bags of each brand should be added? So let the number of bags of brand P fertilizer be X and number of bags of brand Q fertilizer be Y. Now we are given the following table showing the amount of nitrogen, phosphoric acid, potash and chlorine in a bag of each brand. It is also given that the garden needs at least 240 kg of phosphoric acid, at least 270 kg of potash and at most 310 kg of chlorine. Therefore, according to the given conditions, we have the following inequalities. Now from the table we can clearly see that brand P contains 3 kg of nitrogen, 1 kg of phosphoric acid, 3 kg of potash and 1.5 kg of chlorine per bag. And brand Q contains 3.5 kg of nitrogen, 2 kg of phosphoric acid, 1.5 kg of potash and 2 kg of chlorine per bag. Now number of bags of brand P fertilizer is X and each bag contains 1 kg of phosphoric acid. So X bags will contain X kg of phosphoric acid. And number of bags of brand Q fertilizer is Y. And each bag contains 2 kg of phosphoric acid. So Y bags will contain 2 into Y kg of phosphoric acid. Thus the total amount is X plus 2Y. And this is greater than equal to 240. Because we are given that the garden needs at least 240 kg of phosphoric acid. So this is our constraint for phosphoric acid. Now again, number of bags of brand P fertilizer is X and each bag contains 3 kg of potash. So X bags will contain 3 into X kg of potash. And number of bags of brand Q fertilizer is Y and each bag contains 1.5 kg of potash. So Y bags will contain 1.5 into Y kg of potash. Thus the total amount is 3X plus 1.5Y. And this is greater than equal to 270 because we are given that the garden needs at least 270 kg of potash. Now this implies 2x plus y is greater than equal to 180 and this is a constraint for potash. Now again, number of bags of brand P fertilizer is X and each bag contains 1.5 kg of chlorine. So X bags will contain 1.5 into X kg of chlorine and number of bags of brand Q fertilizer is Y and each bag contains 2 kg of chlorine. So Y bags will contain 2 into Y kg of chlorine. So the total amount is 1.5x plus 2y, and this is less than equal to 310, because we are given that the garden needs at most 310 kilograms of chlorine. Now this implies 3x plus 4y is less than equal to 620. This is a constraint for chlorine. Also we have x greater than equal to 0 and y greater than equal to 0, as the number of bags of fertilizer used is greater than equal to 0. Now as the amount of nitrogen in the bags of brand P and brand Q fertilizer is 3 kilograms and 3.5 kilograms per bag respectively, and it is to be maximized, therefore we get the objective function as z is equal to 3x plus 3.5y. Now as number of bags of brand P fertilizer is x and each bag contains 3 kilograms of nitrogen, so x bags will contain 3x kilograms of nitrogen, and number of bags of brand Q fertilizer is y and each bag contains 3.5 kilograms of nitrogen, so y bags will contain 3.5 into y kilograms of nitrogen. So the total amount is 3x plus 3.5y, and therefore the objective function becomes z is equal to 3x plus 3.5y. Thus the linear programming problem becomes maximize z is equal to 3x plus 3.5y subject to the constraints x plus 2y greater than equal to 240, 2x plus y greater than equal to 180, 3x plus 4y less than equal to 620, x greater than equal to 0 and y greater than equal to 0. Now the first inequality is x plus 2y greater than equal to 240, and the line corresponding to this inequality is x plus 2y equal to 240, and the points 0, 120 and 240, 0 lie on this line. The second inequality is 2x plus y greater than equal to 180, and the line corresponding to this inequality is 2x plus y equal to 180, and the points 0, 180 and 90, 0 lie on this line. The third inequality is 3x plus 4y less than equal to 620, and the line corresponding to this inequality is 3x plus 4y equal to 620, and the points 0, 155 and 620 upon 3, 0 lie on this line. Now we have plotted the points 0, 120 and 240, 0 satisfying the equation x plus 2y equal to 240 on the graph, joined them, and we have named the line as AB. We have plotted the points 0, 180 and 90, 0 satisfying the equation 2x plus y equal to 180 on the same graph, joined them, and we have named the line as CD. And we have also plotted the points 0, 155 and 620 upon 3, 0 satisfying the equation 3x plus 4y equal to 620 on the graph, joined them, and we have named the line as EF. The lines AB, CD and EF intersect each other at the points L, M and N. Also we have x greater than equal to 0 and y greater than equal to 0, which implies that the graph lies in the first quadrant only. Thus this shaded portion in the graph is the feasible region satisfying all the given constraints. Here the feasible region is triangle LMN with coordinates of vertices as 20, 140, 40, 100 and 140, 50. So according to the corner point method, which states that the maximum or minimum value of a linear objective function over a convex polygon occurs at some vertex of the polygon, the maximum value. Of Z will occur at any of the above points. Therefore, we will calculate the value of Z is equal to 3x plus 3.5y at these points. Now Z is equal to 3 into 20 plus 3.5 into 140 at 2140. And this comes out to be equal to 550. Z is equal to 3 into 40 plus 3.5 into 100 at 4000. And this comes out to be equal to 470. And Z is equal to 3 into 140 plus 3.5 into 50 at 140.50. And this comes out to be equal to 595. Hence, the maximum value of Z out of these three values is 595, which occurs at (140, 50), or we can say amount of nitrogen is maximum when X is equal to 140 and Y is equal to 50. Thus, maximum amount of nitrogen is 595 kilograms when 140 bags of brand P and 50 bags of brand Q are used. Thus, we write our answer as 140 bags of brand P and 50 bags of brand Q and maximum amount of nitrogen is equal to 595 kilograms. This is our answer. Hope you have understood the solution. Bye and take care.